he said, my name is Jennifer Swiderski, and I am here on behalf of Actors Equity Association, where I am currently the chair of the Member Education Committee. I've been a member for just about under 20 years, and you guys, it's thrilling to be with you all tonight. One of the things that I love most about our people is the sense of community that we support one another, the way that we take care of one another. So here's a little example. My first job out of college, I was fortunate to be in a new show with the one and only Bebe Neuwirth. I was green. I was wide-eyed. I was green. Now in this production, I had a teeny tiny dance teacher and I was struggling a bit with my turns. One day in rehearsals, Bebe walked in and she's called me over, Swiderski, I was thinking about your solo boss turns. Try bringing your feet together in a tighter fifth in the air. She was right. I remember everything about that exchange, including the pair of badass cowboy boots she was wearing. I was very starstruck, and I had a hard time getting over the fact that Bebe Neuwirth was actually talking to and helping me. I awkwardly thanked her, and she was so gentle and generous with my greenness. And in the midst of me fumbling over myself, thanking her, she took the time to share how important she felt that it was to help younger performers. I never forgot that. She didn't have to do that, but it mattered to her. Looking beyond yourself matters. Community matters. And that's why we're here today. There's a long, impressive history of our people looking out for one another. I don't think it's any accident that both Actors Equity Association and the Rehearsal Club were both founded in 1913. They share a lot in common. Both were born out of a need for actors to use their collective voice to improve their situations. So here's a little snapshot of what it used to be like before actors and stage managers were unionized. So we all love what we do. And exploitation of that love was rampant. We weren't paid for rehearsals. There weren't limits to the number of hours we could be required to work. And when a production closed unexpectedly out of town, the entire company was stranded with no way to get home. It became clear that it was time for actors to join the national labor movement and create a union to ensure fair compensation and workplace protections. Equity and the Rehearsal Club are 105 years old. Now for some context, AFT, which is the American Federation of Teachers, is only celebrating their centennial this year. So it gives me goosebumps to think about the long, proud history of actors coming together at the forefront of the national labor movement. So for 105 years and counting, we've been coming together, people just like us, to ensure that someone always has our back and that we always have somewhere to go for help. We are never alone. And that the union has been looking out for us in ways that we don't always realize. So when I first got my card, I was thrilled. It had been a goal of mine since I was a little girl, and I thought, I did it. I was super proud of my union status, and mostly considered it a significant professional benchmark. I kind of knew the basic benefits: access to health care, an enviable pension plan, and access to fair auditions. In fact, I was able to make my Broadway debut thanks to an equity-required audition in a show that was cast by Tara Rubin. What wasn't on my radar were all the other ways that the union looks out for you. Some ways are now a bit obvious, things like fair wages and safe and sanitary working conditions. Some ways aren't on your radar until you need them. For example, I am just about 6 months pregnant. And I don't even presume to know how my world is going to change. I have approximately 1 gazillion questions about how to navigate being a new mom in our industry. But did you know that there's a committee at Equity called the Parents Committee? I didn't. And it's a huge comfort for me to know that I have somewhere to go for help. It's community. A community that will always be there for you. Whether you're on contract or between contracts, you have a safety net. So I hope, and this is for the new graduates, I hope that when you do join the union, you celebrate. But I also hope that you consider it as more than just a professional benchmark. I hope that you will view your membership as a two-way relationship, one that is dependent upon both participation and communication, particularly now. If you have a question or a concern, pick up the phone and ask for help. Everything is confidential. If you have an idea of how something could be improved, please, for the love of God, call us. It's our union, and that's how things improve, by members showing up on behalf of other members to make things better. You have a voice and a say in how things are done. That's our strength. Solidarity is how we are able to require dignified wages and working conditions for a craft that we so dearly love. And in this giant sea of solidarity, there are small pockets for each of us. For the new graduates, it's the extraordinary support of the Rehearsal Club. For me, I'm gonna keep my eye on that parents committee. And for all of us, we work together to continue to look beyond just ourselves and lift each other up. Together, we are strong. Together, we are powerful. And together, we are a community. Thank you so much.